Alrighty, alrighty, that was an amazing song by Uzo. We just left the set, of course, and yes, it was an amazing conversation. You know, we got to know a lot more about Majek Fashek, especially the part where the media is telling us that he was a drug addict and this guy has managed him for a long time and he said he never for once saw drugs. So I think that's exclusive to us, right? Thank us later, right?
Absolutely. Yes. I think you gave me a bit of nostalgia because I don't think that then they had a very good media, social media dissemination of information. You know, it was always on TV. So that was like, you know, proper insight. And I really like that. I like Majek a lot.
I do love Majek Fashek. And yes, of course, like I told you, it's a lineup of super duper personalities today, man. And the next guy in the building is a Nigerian Afro soul artist, Dite, with the real name, Epe. All right, Findite. He's gonna correct me. My apologies. I decided not to ask him because I want him to correct me himself. And he emerges with a trillion performance in this new song titled Closer. He is from Bayelsa State, but he lives and does music in Lagos. He likes getting hurt sometimes, so he can write crazy songs about it. Getting hurt or high. Okay, he's two sides of the same coin. It can be good and it can be bad, depending on the time and place. He loves Afro music and his inspirations are many, so I will mention some in the likes of Ed Sheeran, Bob Marley, Davido, Wald, Wizkid, Usher, Chris Martin. Let's welcome to the stage, to the table, to the world, ladies and gentlemen, man like Dite!
Man.
I haven't seen you this year, have I?
No. I think this is the first time.
Okay, Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year to everyone. Since how do you say your name?
Findite.
Epe.
Findite.
So it's not Lagos, Lekki Epe.
No.
Okay, all right. Our next guest is all about Lekki Epe, so I think.
Nah, that's not true. All right. Anyway, yes, you're very unique. So, and your bio is very interesting as well. I just want to touch on that really quickly because I know that artists do this, but I've never seen any artists to actually admit that that's what they do. Where, you know, they're quite intentional about experiences because they want to feel things and be able to write things and all of that. Do you think that that could be a bad thing?
Well, I think I'll forward that question to Taylor Swift.
Okay. No,
this guy wants to shake the table. Okay, now wants to break off the legs.
Let me get something clear. You know, when it comes to art, there has to be, you know, creativity. There has to be an experience. And even the artist that does normal painting, you have to have an inspiration from somewhere. You get either a feeling, it could be sad, it could be happy. The reason why I said I write songs based on emotions is because it helps me, you know, do a better performance, a better job in what I'm trying to do. Right. You know, because it's better to have an experience that actually really, really pokes you enough to want to write about it. I can't fake it. I can't tell you I'm in love
because
when I'm not.
Do you not enter a relationship and then intentionally break up with the person?
No, okay. I let things flow the way it should flow.
Right.
So when you're supposed to beg, you don't beg.
I
don't want to feel the pain.
The amazing part is there are parts where I had to beg, and it still ended up to be the same way it happened. The occurrence was still the same thing. There are places where I did not beg and it was still the same answer. So it's not about what you say, it's about how I think it goes with the flow.
Yeah
If you're going with an experience, let me say, for example, you're in love with someone and then something happens along the way, it's not intentional for it to happen, it just happens. Sometimes we grow out of love. You get the person you used to see today and you're happy.
You know
about
what? I want to give you the opportunity to like do the first verse of Closer so we can actually feel some of the pain you felt while you were making it.
Closer is not a sad song or an emotional song.
Whatever it is, we'll just want to feel that.
Oh, let him sing the song he wants to sing. How about
okay,
that?
What song do you want to sing?
That
we can actually feel your emotion in that song. Just the first verse or a few lines that will actually make us feel that pain.
I'm still going to sing Closer because I think the song has an emotion in it as well.
All right, let's do the first verse of Closer. Okay.
Baby, draw me closer. When you turn your waist, you got me so confused, baby. I'm confused, baby. What do you want from me? Cause I can see through every situation.
Oh wow!
Okay.
Wow.
So the chorus is like,
"Baby, you need
to drop closer to my life." As you they sing, and they find the baby for my mind. I don't see one picture of the girl.
That was hot.
Okay.
I have to
okay.
say that was really hot because it's not just about, I mean, I was going to say like, even the way you talk here, you can kind of tell that you sing. I don't know. I don't know if you know what I mean. There's some people that you hear how they talk and my son can't sing because it's really having that like huskiness. Husky, but you also have something like sexy about that that's also sprinkled in there.
I see my body. I can tell if it's sexy though. Don't be looking at me funny, bro.
You know you can sing
but
that
you
for
know,
sure.
But you know, that doesn't come naturally. That's not like something that just happens, right? I feel like that comes with experience and just honestly harnessing your craft. So why did you choose that type of style? I mean, you're already doing the eye closing thing and it's like, honestly, but like, you know, what drew you to that? Is that how you are as a person, or you just find that your songs sound nicer when you use that style? Like, you know, talk to me about that.
Well, on that note, I would say I grew into that particular, you know, time frame because my music took time. Like Missy says, he's in love with Pray, a song I did a long time ago. And that song was a song I did when I was very, very sad. Like, you know, when you struggle so much in Lagos and it just gets overwhelming.
Yeah.
And then you call your mom and just break out in tears and be like, do you know, I'm just going to pour it out all on you.
Yeah.
And then she prays for me and she says, don't worry, it'll all be okay. So that song is just related to that experience with my mom.
Favorite, you know.
You get. So now, right now, Afro Soul is what I do, for real, because I feel my voice has an energy that I can push further. Like, I can go...
Show off, darling, it does. Show
yeah,
off,
I can go further with it. So I focus more on vocals. So I make sure I write on that. You know.
And what is that scene like? Because most of the things that are, you know, commercial and, you know, out there are, the, like I like to say, Pangolo music, which is not bad. I like Pangolo. I'm not bashing anyone
you
now.
To it.
Yeah, so, you know...
You won us a Grammy. How,
Yes, we did.
Bonaboy is classic.
That's not Bonaboy. But anyway, I want to know from you. I'm giving Bonaboy a few days now.
We don't mind.
Anyway,
you're Bonaman.
Anyway, from your perspective as an artist in Nigeria, this climate, how is the acceptance of your kind of genre, your style of singing, your lyrics, all of that, how has that been for you?
Well, I think, like I said, this was like a growth, the new Afro soul music. And I must say, I'm actually very, very happy with the response I'm getting from it.
Okay.
Close Out was released like 5 years ago, and it trends on Twitter a lot of times that I've seen. It's playing very well on Apple Music. In fact, Apple Music gave it a star.
Wow.
And this is just 5 days to, you know, like 5 days from the release, that you know, on the 10th. Wow. So I think it's amazing. The response I'm getting from people, it's good for the crowd because there's more coming. And I feel like I'm sharing my thoughts to people and they can relate to it. So
I enjoy it. So we're running out of time. So I'm just going to ask you, you know, the final questions. And then I don't know if you can merge both of them together. So how are you going to deal with comparison? Because I remember I was playing Closer on my sound bar and it was really loud.
It wasn't like you have sound bar.
Sound bars are easy. You can get sound bars.
Calm
down. Do you know I'm using the cheap one? It lost your mind. So like I was saying, I was playing and it was really loud. And then my neighbor was like, oh, what world new song is that? Do you understand? And I was like, nah, this ain't world. Shege, I brag. I use you to brag. And, you know, I've only got a number two, you know. So at the end of the day, what I'm trying to say is that, are you going to handle comparisons, you know, with people saying, oh, this guy sounds like this guy. This guy sounds like this guy. And secondly, tell the fans where they can find you real quick and where they can find you.
Okay. On that note, I believe that I don't really do comparisons. I do what I, you know, feel is best for me. Like a while ago, Davido heard Closer. And he was like, man, this boy is so good. It sounds like world. And I was like, why is the picture of world coming on? But it's cool. I can see the resemblance.
But world is family to you as well, right?
Sorry?
World is family.
Yeah, I love world. Like, I love his music. I love his craft. He gives us inspiration to want to move further. So I don't compare. I just feel I do what I want to do. And if you see any comparisons, that's for you to judge. But I'm cool where I am.
All right, so where can the fans find you real quick?
And your singles and everything.
Yeah, on IG, I'm at Dieter_Etaily. Etaily is Etaily.
Yeah.
But if you just type Dieter, it'll definitely pop up.
How do you spell Dieter?
Dieter, D-I-T-E-H.
Okay.
And on Twitter, is still Dieter. But like because of the whole Lando's, people are answering your name sometimes, you have to swap. So I use at Jason Ape. But if you click into Jason Ape, you get to see Dieter's profile there.
Alrighty. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you so much for having me, guys.
Sipping and spilling tea with us. And tea time continues right after this break. Stay with us.